Boys and girls at Fieldcrest in music class, this is a video on how to read chords and for the 11 chord chart we have in school, okay? So you take a G if you're a right-handed player. This is the chord you'll see. You take it, you turn it this way, and you apply it to the neck of your guitar. These are the frets, first fret, second fret, third fret, and these are the strings. Bottom strings, so string 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, or E, A, D, G, B, E. But just knowing them from the bottom up is good enough. So the G you can see, nothing in the first fret, finger 2 in the 5th string, and then finger 3 and 4 in the next string. So the next string, so top string and bottom string. You can use these fingers too, but the G is 5th string, and then 6th string and 1st string. Looks like this. Sounds like that. And the next chord in the progression is a C chord. And we're going to turn it sideways and put it on the neck of the guitar. So here is the C. You take it like this, put it on the neck of my guitar, and you can see it's finger 1 on the 2nd string, finger 2 on the 4th string, finger 3 on the 5th string, on the 1st, 2nd, 3rd fret. So 1st fret, 2nd string, 2nd fret, 4th string, and then 3rd fret, 5th string. That's a C. There it is. The next chord on the progression is the F chord. And you're going to see it looking like this on any piece of music. Too high. There we go. And the F looks like this on your guitar. You can see there's two ones here because in the F, you lay your finger down. There's a line connecting two. So you lay your finger down to cover the bottom two. You can cover 3 or 4. It doesn't matter. So finger 1 covers string 1, string 2. There it is in the neck of my guitar. Finger 2 is on the 1, 2, 3rd string. Finger 4 is on the 1, 2, 3, 4th string, or sorry, finger 3. So it looks like this. Lay it flat across 2. I think I get to 3 or 4. Finger 2 on 1, 2, 3. Finger 3 on 1, 2, 3, 4. That's your F chord right there. Alrighty. Sounds like this. The next chord is a D. Looks like this. And on the neck of my guitar, I'm going to take it, turn it this way, and when you see it, it's like you're looking down on your guitar. So you can see it is nothing in the first fret. And then first string and third string, and they have, the people that made this chart have finger 1, finger 2. I do it the other way. It doesn't really matter. And then third fret, finger 3 goes on the 2nd string right there. So if I put that on my guitar, it looks like this. First and third string, and then 2nd string right there. All right, looks like that. Sounds like this. There we go, I had it down there. So there it is. So first and third, and then second. That's the D chord. The next chord on the progression at school is the A chord. It's right here. You take that one here, turn it this way, and apply it to the neck of the guitar. And I don't use fingers 2, 3, 4. I use fingers 1, 2, 3. It doesn't matter. But you can see there's nothing in the first fret. There's the first fret. And in the second fret, right here, it starts almost at the bottom. You miss the bottom string, and you go string 2, 3, 4, okay? It looks like this. Now don't put it down on one string, or using one finger like you can on a uke, because you may not get a clean sound. So I use these three fingers, finger or string 2, 3, 4. Right there, it looks like that on the guitar. Sounds like this. The next chord on the progression at school is an A minor. Here it is, applied to the neck of the guitar. So you're going to turn sideways. There's the nut. Here's the nut. First fret, finger one. Second fret, finger two and three. Okay, so I'm going to put that on my guitar. Finger one, it's right here, second string. And then two and three are like this, right there. Don't do this, it's kind of a weird thing. It feels more comfortable this way, with these two fingers there. So there's A minor on the neck of my guitar. All right, have a good look. There it is. Looks like that, sounds like this. The next chord in the progression here at school is the A minor 7th. It's an easy transition from the A minor, because all you do is take off one finger. Here it is on the neck of my guitar. First fret, second string, and then second fret, the fourth string. So it's right here, just those two right there, and it goes from the A minor. From the A minor, you just lift up that finger, and you have a whole new chord, A minor 7th. There it is right there. Looks like this, and sounds like this. The next chord on the progression is an E chord. And the E chord, here's my guitar, is the same formation as the A minor, but it's just up one set of strings. So you know the A minor is this, you just move them up one, like that. So looking at the chart here, it's finger one on 1, 2, 3rd string, and then these two fingers on the 4th string and 5th string, okay? So string, first fret, 3rd string, right there. And then the next two strings are right there. Don't do it this way, it's not as comfortable as this way. So finger one is there, 3rd string, finger two on the 5th string, finger three on the 4th string. And that's what that looks like. Here's what it sounds like. The next chord on the transition is the E minor. And if you're playing an E chord and you want an E minor, you just take off one finger. So here's the E minor. Alrighty. Get that out of the way. Here's the E minor. Or sorry, the E chord. Oh, we're doing the E minor, my bad. Here's the E minor. Two fingers. The people that put this chart out said finger two, finger three. I don't use two and three, I use one and two. But it's nothing in the first fret. And then almost at the top, so it's string one, two, three, string four, and string five in the second fret. So I count up one, two, three, string four, and string five right there. Looks like this. You can do it this way too. Sounds like this. The next chord in the transition at school is a B minor. Put that right there. Here's the B minor coming at you. Put it on the guitar like this. Nothing in the first fret. First finger on the first string. Second finger on the second string. And then finger three and four on the 3rd and 4th string, like that, okay? A couple ways you can do it. So finger one, 2nd fret, finger two, 3rd fret, finger four, up here like that. So that's this chord applied. You sometimes don't even need this one. You can just use this, one, two, three. So string one, string two, string three, like that. You can also bar it like this. That's harder on an acoustic. So here's this chord right here, or you can do that and ignore that finger. Okay, that's a B minor. And the last chord on the progression here at school is this one. It's a B7th, and it's tricky. It's tricky, and it's kind of awkward and hard to do. I won't lie to you. So there it is. I'm gonna turn it sideways and put it on the neck of my guitar. You can see it's finger one on the 4th string, and then you alternate 1st string, 3rd string, 5th string using those fingers right there. So I'm going to get this one first. Once you get that, the other ones are a little bit easier. So 1st fret, 4th string. So One, two, three, four. And then first string, third string, and fifth string right there. Okay, so you alternate the strings. Here's what it looks like. Here's what it sounds like. Alrighty. I hope this helps. Have fun. Bye-bye.